Hello, everybody. I'm Dr. Samuel Buckner, director of the USF Muscle Lab. We presented at Pecha Kucha a year ago and talked about everything we were going to do. So it seemed like a timely opportunity to have one of my master's students, Noam Yitzchaki, tell you a little bit about what we've been up to for the past year and all the exciting things that are going on in the lab.
Thank you, Dr. Buckner. Good afternoon and welcome, everyone. My name is Noam Yitzchaki. I'm a master's student in the exercise science program. And today, I'll be presenting you some of our work from our lab, the USF Muscle Lab. Very tiny, but very productive. Before we get started, I would like to review some of our goals, some of our focus. Our main goal is to study skeletal muscle adaptation. We study muscle growth, we study muscle strength, and we study muscle swelling. Mainly on biceps, that's the easiest to measure with our tools. I would like to review and talk a little bit, how do we image a muscle? We image. We have several ways to image a muscle. We have the A mode on your left. That's the easiest and the simplest one to measure. We have the B mode. That's what we usually, in general, according to the literature, most of the studies use. More advanced technique is the MRI and the DEXA. But in our lab, we mainly use both of them. We're tracking the muscle. We're tracking the muscle growth throughout post-training intervention. And that's just an example of the images from the B mode on your left and the A mode. They are slightly different, as you can tell. You can see both of them are biceps image between the bone interface to the fat layer. That's the skeletal muscle tissue. And that's what led us to think a little bit and design our first study from our lab. We compared between these two and we wanted to see if the A mode can detect the same changes as the B mode. So the subject, the individual, came to our lab, trained, we induced swelling, and then we measure and compare between them. Good news for labs that don't have the B mode, the more advanced technique, good news for them that the A mode can detect the same acute changes as the B mode. As you can see in these bars, there are no significant differences, and that's why we suggested that A mode can be used to detect acute changes in muscle thickness. In our lab, we also measure echo intensity, which echo intensity, it's according to the resistance training literature, it's a software that analyzes and quantifies the image by the colors between the scale of 0 to 255 and distinguish between muscle swelling and the real skeletal muscle tissue. However, in 2018, our colleagues from Ole Miss found in their paper that tilting the probe as small as 2 degrees might change the picture, might change the color, and therefore might change the numbers. So that's led us to think a little bit more critically about this measurement and a little bit more about what is the meaning of echo intensity. And that's how we got to our next study that just got published last year. 49 resistant trained individual, they came to our lab, we induced again muscle swelling, and we measure it. The big change in this study that we accounted for the protein. As you can see, we attached the level to standardize the degrees. Every measurement was in the same degrees. That's our finding, very interesting. Although you can see a significant changes in the muscle thickness, when we analyze it with echo intensity, we couldn't find any changes in the muscle thickness. And that's led us to think even more critically when we read about the echo intensity in the literature. And that's how we got to this study, the muscle damage study. One of the indirect indicators for muscle damage is the long-term swelling. So if I said that we induce an acute changes, that's the long-term swelling, that's a kind of chronic changes in the muscle, and we measure it post 24 and 48, and we find very interesting finding as well. There were no direction to the finding, and that's led us to think even more about the meaning of echo intensity and what is echo intensity. We suggested, based on this study, that due to the inconsistency, echo intensity cannot be detected acute or long term. In our lab, we also deal with different training techniques. One of them is the blood flow restriction. It's basically a technique that you occlude the blood that goes, partially occlude the blood that goes into the muscle, fully occlude the blood that goes out of the muscle and train. According to the literature, you can train with low load and get the same adaptation as high load. It has a few different applications. Upper extremities, as you can see, the guy over there train with low load and hopefully he'll get some adaptation as high load. Lower extremities, rehabilitation. It has a lot to do in rehabilitation. They can recover with low load, and you don't need any advanced technique to use it. But we wanted to see how low we can get with the loads. So we used a study that no load at all, just the individual just squeeze their muscle as hard as possible with blood occlusion, and we wanted to measure some acute cardiovascular or muscular responses. We found that yes, there are some acute changes. Our lab is very productive and very it's still active. These days we are working on a year-long study, most of the literature based on 8 weeks, 12 weeks, or 6 months. We wanted to track muscle growth for a year long, and we are still in data collection. Some of them are about to finish. Also, we are working on a study that on muscle thickness throughout the menstrual cycle in female. Most of the literature exclude females from, based on no evidence, due to their menstrual cycle, and we wanted to check it. And another study that we are working on is the last one. We are about to finish data collection. It's a training program, 8 weeks training program. We compare two different training programs, same individual. It's a within subject design. And we would like to see if muscle growth can explain strength. Very interesting topic, very hot topic in the literature. And we are very excited to finish that. All this work wouldn't happen without this great team that coming on a daily basis, helping us to collect the data and doing a great job every day. Thank you, Dr. Buckner, for your dedication to bring us, to let us be a better scientist. And thank you guys for listening and for your time.